morning class. We have to start with the leftover portion of capital and revenue expenditure and income, chapter number 18. Another part for the same chapter. As you all know that we have discussed a few days back, why do we need to distinguish between capital and revenue items? Why is there a requirement to distinguish the items, whether they are of capital nature or they belong to the revenue nature? The reason is, first thing, all the revenue items are taken into trading and profit and loss account, but all the capital items are shown in the balance sheet. If the items are categorized properly and posted in the correct ledger account, there will be less chances of misleading information. Continuing the same chapter, let me first give you an outline. Here in this chapter, we have already covered meaning and difference between revenue and capital expenditure, meaning and difference between revenue and capital received. Now in this session, we will cover capital and revenue profits with their difference, capital and revenue losses along with a difference, capital and revenue income and a difference between the two, and the last topic, that is deferred revenue expenditure. In this topic, students, after doing the presentation, after attending the session, they will be able to understand and define the meaning of capital expenditure, revenue expenditure, capital received and revenue received, calculate and comment on the effect on profit and asset valuation of the incorrect treatment of capital or revenue expenditure and capital or revenue receipts. There are top 5 international courier services in India, and they are Blue Dart, Ekart, DTDC, DHL and FedEx. There are few more local and popular courier services providers in India, such as Ecom Express, Gojavas, Shiprocket and ExpressBees. Asset Express's Cargo Private Limited started by the name AGCS Express, then it became private limited company on 2010 with global vision and sole mission to deliver your document with world class service. Today, Asset Express Cargo Private Limited is a 5-year-old company with a 700 pickup and 1,000 delivery points in all over India, which has been operated by our own office, franchises and business associates. Asset Express's cargo have a fantastic infrastructure, good transportation facilities and superb systems. Last year, it sold 2 of its cargo carrying trucks, which cost them 8,25,000 in the year 2014. Both were sold at 8,30,000. Therefore, the capital profit for this company in this case is 5,000. So, profit earned on the sale of a fixed asset is known as capital profit. For example, if a surplus machine costing 3,000 is sold for 4,000, the business earns a profit of rupees 1,000. It is a capital profit. It is profit earned from the sale of fixed assets or when a company issues shares to raise its capital. They are not earned through carrying out the normal business of a company. The formula is sales price minus cost basis is equal to capital gain. For example, suppose you purchase 100 shares of stock for rupee 1, each for a total value of rupees 100. After 3 months, the stock price rises to rupees 5 per share, making your investment worth rupees 500. If you sell the stock at this point, you will have made a profit of rupees 400. It's a kind of capital profit then. Another examples of capital profits or capital incomes are share premium, सेल ऑफ अ फिक्स्ड एसेट फॉर अ वैल्यू मोर देन दैट फॉर विच इट वॉज परचेज्ड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल कैपिटल गेन ऑफ 1,50,000 अराइजिंग वेन बिल्डिंग बॉट फॉर 2 लाख इज सोल्ड फॉर 3,50,000. यू कैन सी इन द पिक हियर, सपोज इफ यू बाय अ स्टॉक फॉर $50, सेल इट फॉर $70, देन अ कैपिटल गेन वुड बी $20. ओनली द प्रॉफिट रियलाइज्ड ओवर एंड अबव द कॉस्ट ऑफ द फिक्स्ड एसेट शुड बी टेकन एज कैपिटल प्रॉफिट एंड शुड बी ट्रांसफर्ड टू कैपिटल रिजर्व. बट the profit realized over and above book value of the asset till it does not exceed the original cost of the asset should be taken as revenue profit and credited to profit and loss account. Let us take another example. Navneet Education Limited is an Indian company that is in the business of educational and children book publishing, scholastic stationery and non-paper stationery products. It operates in 3 segments, publication, stationery and others. Its products are Navneet, Vikas, Gala and Yuva. Its revenue is 931.1 crores INR, US$130 million in 2019. It sold its products at different retail stores and earns revenue. When you compare this particular company with its peer, that is the other group of stationery business houses, Navneet is much ahead of its peer in both stationery and publishing business. ITC, which sells under brand name of Classmate, has share less half. Amongst the publishers, Bluebird in 2010 was 20% behind Navneet. We have Navneet, Macmillan, Repro India, Bluebird, but the sale of Navneet is the highest one. So, revenue profit is a profit made by trading. For example, merchandise costing ₹6,000 is sold for ₹9,000. The profit of ₹3,000 is a revenue profit. Revenue profits are transferred to income statement of the year in which they occur because they arise out of regular and nominal business activities. Profit earned in the ordinary course of business is called revenue profit. Revenue profit includes discount received, profit from the sale of goods, commission received, interest received, profit on sale of fixed assets, that is excess of cost over written down value, profit on subletting and many more. Subleasing, which is also referred to as subletting, is a situation where a new tenant shares the rented space with the original tenant. The Supreme Court has held that a tenant can be evicted if he or she sublets the premises to another person without the consent of the landlord. I am a subtenant. Who is my legal relationship with? Head landlord, immediate landlord and subtenant. Head landlord owns the property. Immediate landlord pays rent to the head landlord. Subtenant pays rent to the immediate landlord. They have no legal relationship with the head landlord. Difference between capital and revenue profit. Mode, first of all, on the basis of mode of earning. Capital profit is earned by selling assets, shares and debentures at a price more than their book value and face value. Revenue profit is earned in the ordinary course of the business. Next basis is distribution. Capital profit is not available for the distribution to shareholders as dividend. Revenue profit is available for the distribution to shareholders as dividend. Next basis is usage. Capital profit is transferred to capital reserve and is used for meeting capital losses. Revenue profit is used to distribute dividend and create reserve and fund for various purposes. Next basis of distinction is treatment. Capital profit is shown on the liability side of the balance sheet as capital reserve. Revenue profit is shown as debit balance on the debit side of the trading and profit and loss account and on asset side of the balance sheet as accumulated losses. Then here is an example of Celebration Mall situated at Batala Road, Amritsar. After demonetization, when it was announced that a hospital will be constructed in place of this mall, all its branded stores like Zara, Lakme, Reliance, they were closed and the owner suffered great capital loss. Now only brand factory sales, Cinepolis and McDonald's are in running position there. So what is a capital loss? It occurs when a capital asset is sold for less than it is based on. A capital loss is the loss incurred when a capital asset such as an investment or real estate decreases in value. This loss is not realized until the asset is sold for a price then it is lower than the original purchase price. Capital loss is the difference between a lower selling price and a higher purchase price, resulting in a financial loss for the seller. For example, if an investor bought a house for ₹2,50,000 and sold the house 5 years later for 2 lakh, the investor realizes a capital loss of 50,000. To calculate your capital gains or losses on a particular trade, subtract your basis from your net proceeds. The net proceeds equals the amount you received after paying any expenses of the sale. For example, if you sell stock for ₹3,624, that is ₹3,624, but you paid a ₹12 commission, your net proceeds are ₹3,612. That is deducting amount of ₹12 from the original amount and then your stock will be real worth. So, another example which we can take to understand the topic, Avenue Supermarts Limited, which runs hypermarket chain DMart. DMart reported a 30% decline in revenue hurt by the COVID-19 pandemic and consequent lockdown. Consolidated revenue declined 33.2% year on year to 3,883.2 crore in the quarter ended June due to movement restrictions across the country to limit the spread of COVID-19, according to the company's exchange filing. The retail chain's quarter 1 financial year 21 net profit fell by 87%. So, a revenue loss occurs when a company makes less from operations than expected due to external and internal factors. The loss of potential customers, restrictions on business, and changes in the market can all lead to significant revenue loss. Ordinarily, a revenue loss is one which a business sustains by sale of goods of the business or by destruction of stock in trade or non-recovery of any amount due from the persons who were to pay the amount. For instance, when we discuss it with the help of an example, suppose if the government places restrictions on trading amounts for investment banks, banks encounter revenue loss from the lost income they could receive for more trading. Companies also experience revenue loss when technology changes. Here is a difference between revenue losses versus capital losses. Capital loss, this is a loss suffered by a business on the sale of fixed asset or it is incurred on raising capital of a joint stock company. This is not a recurring loss and is not made in the ordinary course of the business. For example, a machinery having a book value of $50,000 is sold for $45,000. The loss of $5,000 is a capital loss. In this way, a company issued shares of $1,00,000 at the rate of 10% discount. The loss of $10,000, that is 10% of $1,00,000 is a capital loss. Capital loss is shown in the balance sheet on the asset side as a fictitious asset which is gradually written off out of the profits every year. Then when we talk about revenue loss, it is made in the ordinary course or day-to-day operation of a business, such as loss on sale of goods, etc. Revenue loss appears in the profit and loss account or income statement in the year in which it occurs. Let us take an example. If a piece of land is purchased for $5 lakh USD and a year later it is sold for $6 lakh USD, the seller has a capital gain of $1 lakh USD, which is included in his or her capital income for that year. Capital gains tax is payable on the disposal of jewelry, coins and stamps, antiques, paintings or other artworks, sets of things, example a chess set, property that is not the main home, the main home if let out or used for a business, business assets. Capital gain is denoted as the net profit that an investor makes after selling a capital asset exceeding the price of purchase. The entire value earned from selling a capital asset is considered as taxable income. Rita wants to renovate her old house. She has a fixed deposit with State Bank of Patiala. She mortgaged her FD and raised a credit limit against FD of Rs. 6 lakh and she got a loan of 5,40,000. Her new overdraft account has been opened in her name with the same branch. Then the bank transferred an amount equals to Rs. 5,40,000 in Rita's overdraft account as a loan from bank, which is not taxable. But contrary to this, FD amount of 6 lakh is taxable. Here, the capital income on the part of the bank would be 60,000. That is 6 lakh minus 5,40,000. Capital gains. They may also refer to a different form of profit received from an asset that refers to investment income in the form of cash flow or passive income that arises in relation to real assets such as property, financial assets such as shares, stocks or bonds and intangible assets. A capital gain refers to profit that results from the sale of capital asset such as stock, bond or real estate where the sale price exceeds the purchase price. The gain is the difference between a higher selling price and a lower purchase price. So, when there is a difference between a higher selling price and the lower purchase price, then a capital gain is earned. Then, we can also discuss with the help of revenue income. Suppose if you have a lobby space of 25 square feet or at least a 50 square feet room, you can take the franchisee of ATM by Tata Communications Payment Solution. TCPS provides you to have a dealership with them by taking the franchisee. Electricity charges are borne by the company with a security deposit of 2 to 3 lakhs. A franchise will earn Rs. 15 for every cash withdrawal and Rs. 5 for every non-cash transaction. Usually, an ATM starts making money when it clocks 100 transactions per day. So, the income depends on the number of transactions. How you earn from an ATM franchisee? If monthly charges are 25,000 to 30,000, your security deposit is 2 to 3 lakhs. Daily transactions calculate your monthly income. Suppose if daily transactions are 50, your monthly income could be 19,500. मोर द नंबर ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शंस मोर विल बी योर मंथली इनकम. देन टाइप्स ऑफ रेवेन्यू, द सेल ऑफ गुड्स प्रोडक्ट्स और मर्केंडाइज, द सेल ऑफ सर्विसेज सच एज कंसल्टिंग, रेंटल इनकम फ्रॉम अ कमर्शियल प्रॉपर्टी, नोटिस द यूज ऑफ इनकम, द सेल ऑफ टिकट्स ऑफ अ कॉन्सर्ट, इंटरेस्ट इनकम फ्रॉम लेंडिंग. रेवेन्यू इज द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ इनकम जनरेटेड बाय द सेल ऑफ गुड्स और सर्विसेज रिलेटेड टू द कंपनीज प्राइमरी ऑपरेशंस. इनकम और नेट इनकम इज अ कंपनीज टोटल अर्निंग्स और प्रॉफिट. बोथ रेवेन्यू एंड नेट इनकम आर यूजफुल इन डिटर्मिनिंग द फाइनेंशियल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ अ कंपनी, बट दे आर नॉट इंटरचेंजेबल. रेवेन्यू इज योर नॉर्मल इनकम फ्रॉम सेल्स ऑफ गुड्स और द सप्लाई ऑफ सर्विसेज. कैपिटल इनकम इज इनकम दैट अराइजेस फ्रॉम एन एसेट बिकॉज ऑफ द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम, नॉट बिकॉज द एसेट इज बीइंग यूज्ड. सो बाइंग लैंड एट $2 million एंड सेलिंग एट $3 million जनरेट्स कैपिटल इनकम ऑफ $1 million. Now we can study about a distinction between capital and revenue receipts. Capital receipts includes amount realized by the sale of fixed assets or by issue of shares or debentures. Revenue receipts includes amount realized by sale of goods or rendering services. Capital receipt is a receipt in substitution of a source of income. Revenue receipt is a receipt in substitution of an income. Capital receipts are the amount received for surrender of certain rights under an agreement and is known as a capital receipt because a capital asset is being given up in the form of these rights. Revenue receipts are the amount received as compensation under an agreement for the loss of future receipts and is known as a revenue receipt. Then, on the basis of the study we have done so far, we can now answer the different items, whether they are of capital or revenue nature. Suppose if you purchase a machinery, it is of capital nature. Computer repairs, revenue expenditure. Cost of installation of a new machinery, again a capital expenditure. Sale of toys in toy manufacturing company, it's a capital expenditure. A business sells a car at the end of 2010 for €5,000, which was bought €6,000 in January 2010. It's a capital gain. Next term, which is very important, that is deferred revenue expenditure. Raj and Shamita were blessed with a baby girl this year. For her future, parents decided to take a life insurance policy named as Jeevan Lakshya. They would have to pay a premium of ₹4,678 per quarter. No doubt it seems a big expenditure for a middle class parent, but it will yield high profits on the date of maturity. As per the regulator for insurance policies with term above 10 years, the net reduction in yield should not be more than 2.25% at maturity. And for insurance policies with term less than or equal to 10 years, the net reduction in yield should not be more than 3% at maturity. For example, if you take a policy for a term of more than 10 years, the post-cost return on the maturity will be at least 5.75% at an 8% per annum gross return or gross yield. Deferred revenue expenditure is an expenditure which is revenue in nature and incurred during an accounting period. However, related benefits are to be derived in multiple future accounting periods. These expenses are unusually large in amount and essentially the benefits are not consumed within the same accounting period. For example, revenue used for advertisement is deferred revenue expenditure because it will keep showing its benefit over the period of 2 to 3 years. Another examples of deferred revenue expenditures are prepaid expenses, exceptional losses, services rendered and fictitious assets. So in this session we have covered the following topics. We have covered the meaning of capital expenditure, revenue expenditure, capital receipts and revenue receipts, calculated and commented also on the effect on profit, and asset valuation of the incorrect treatment of capital or revenue expenditure and capital or revenue receipts. Also, we have drawn out a difference between revenue and capital expenditure. Read the chapter thoroughly, follow the given reference links so that you can know about the topic. Then you can also answer the questions. State whether the following are capital revenue or deferred revenue expenditure. First is purchase of new laptop for office use. Second is heavy advertisement expenses for launching a new product. Third, wages paid to machine operators. Fourth one, installation expenses paid on machinery purchased. Fifth is amount spent on increasing the seating capacity in a cinema hall. What kind of expenditure it is? Is it a capital expenditure, revenue expenditure, deferred revenue expenditure? None of the above. Third question, expenditure incurred 20,000 for trial run of a newly installed business would be on the basis of pre-operative expenses, tariffs type, revenue expenditure, prepaid revenue expenditure, deferred revenue expenditure or capital expenditure. Dash items are to be shown in the balance sheet. Capital, revenue, expense or loss. Dash is received in the normal course of business. Capital received, capital expenditure. Revenue received, revenue, loss. Next question, amount spent on increasing the seating capacity in a cinema hall, what it is? Is it a capital expenditure, revenue expenditure, deferred revenue expenditure or none of the above? Next one, capital expenditure incurred rupees 20,000 for trial run of a newly installed machinery will be preliminary expense, revenue expenditure, capital expenditure, deferred revenue expenditure. Amount received from IDBI as a medium term loan for augmenting working capital would be regarded as capital expenditure, revenue received, revenue expenditure. So this was all about the chapter of capital and revenue. And in this we have covered all the different types of capital and revenue items along with its nature, difference and also the concept of deferred revenue.